Hi again, everyone. When East Grand Forks baseball beat DGF last week, they accomplished something that had never been done before. They punched their ticket to the state tournament. Today, they were back on the diamond taking on Minnehaha Academy in the state quarterfinals. Green Wave trailing 2-0 in the second, but have the bases juiced. Chance Borden lifts the offering to right field. Carter Beck scores, makes it 2-1. Now in the third, Cole Hammergren bounces one to third. The throw is bobbled. Safe at first allows Donnie Musgrove to score, and that ties things at two. Red Hawks take a 3-2 lead, and in the fourth at two, Jesse Retzlaff singles through the left side. Another run comes in to score. The Green Waves see their state title dreams come to an end, falling 11-2.
No matter how things end, this has been very successful, but you know, it's always fun, of course, to get to the state tournament and get a win out of the deal too. So we're gonna come back tomorrow, hopefully, you know, play our game and play hard. I mean, we just have to keep throwing strikes, making plays, and then get our bats going again.
In Class A, BGMR falls to Parker's Prairie. Derek Knutson goes 2-for-3 for the Gators. Legion baseball tonight. Thief River Falls playing the Grand Forks Royals. Dylan Manderud in a jam on the mound, 2-on-1 down in the first, but he gets Brock Reller to ground into the double play, and the threat is over. Second inning, the Bandits had the bases loaded, but Blaise Monette gets the call, strike three. The offense would explode later in this game for both teams, with the Royals winning by one. Well, the rookies have been named. Today, the UND men's hockey team announcing the 8 members of the incoming freshman class. And there's a local flavor with this group. 4 of the 8 are area athletes. Former Grand Forks Central standout Casey Johnson, 2 East Grand Forks natives in Colton Pullman and Dixon Bowen, and Roseau's Zach Yon. Not to mention Cole Smith, who's from Brainerd, not our viewing area, but close by, which is important for head coach Brad Berry, who says bringing in local athletes helps build the culture of the program.
You know, obviously, they have to make sure that they are capable of coming in and playing at our level, and they are. But also, too, is they grew up around our program. They know the inside and out of our program as far as, you know, being from a young boy, watching our games and knowing what our culture is all about. And that's highly important for success because, you know, through good times and adversity, you know, they're familiar with our program. And again, that's very important going forward.
Also joining the team next year, Tyson Jost, who's projected to go in the top 20 next week's draft, Ludvig Hoff of Norway, and Andrew Pesky, a defenseman from Ontario. Well, WDAZ has been your home for the NBA Finals, and that continued tonight with Game 6. Warriors can close it out, but Cleveland had some different ideas. Second quarter, J.R. Smith puts it up. Tristan Thompson slams it down. Thompson had a double-double, 15 points, 16 boards. That's a 17-point lead for the Cavs. The Warriors trying to keep it close. Steph Curry from beyond the arc. He leads his team with 30, and they're within 10. But this night was all about the King. Smith and alley-oop to LeBron James, 2 of his 41 tonight. Cleveland forces a Game 7 with a 14-point victory. The Minnesota Twins back home opening a 4-game set with the Yankees. Twins get the scoring started. Bottom of the fourth, Eduardo Nunez finds a hole on the left side. Max Kepler scores. It's 1-0. Yanks tie it at 1 in the sixth. Then in the seventh, Didi Gregorius takes Fernando Abad deep, brings home 2 others with him. That's a difference maker as the Yankees win 4-1. U.S. Junior Amateur Qualifying Tournament at the Fargo Country Club today. Some local athletes participating, playing 36 holes this afternoon. Hole 5, Red River's Gavin Loeschleider, a birdie putt from the fridge. Inches away, he would putt in for par. Finishes 16th overall. Now to 11, Keaton Wolf, a beautiful approach, chips it close to the hole. He taps in for par. He's 5 over in his second round, finishes in 6th. Staying on 11, Adam Van Raden with a chance for birdie from 10 feet away. Almost drops the putt. Great showing by the Red River standout. Finishes 3rd overall at plus 7. A hole in one at King's Walk today. Tim Straub aces the 4th hole with a pitching wedge, and there were 3 witnesses. So great job for him. He's got an ace, but how many aces do you have this year, Matt?
I've played cards a few times.
I don't think that counts.
3 witnesses, no pictures?
It was late tonight, so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, maybe.
They didn't have the flash on.
I guess not.
All right, thank you, Maddie.